Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. Hope you guys are doing all right. I've been trying to make some videos, and the Lord wanted me not to make those videos at this time. The Lord had been showing me some stuff, but he told me not to talk about it at this time. Brothers and sisters, what can I say? I tried to make the videos, and I couldn't do it last night. So I thought I'd come on here this morning. I've been praying and seeking the Lord, and the Lord had given me a message. First, I just want to say, if you guys who watch my videos, you know that I don't have a dog in the hunt, as they say, or, you know, horse in the race about all this doctrinal stuff. A lot of times, brothers and sisters, I don't. I'm a truth seeker, and I know lots of you who are normally watchers of my videos, you're truth seekers. You know, and then there's those few who are, they live and die, you know, their whole life seems to be obsessed with trolling around the internet to spout their one, you know, some doctrine, whether it be anti-rapture or calculating the date of the rapture, pre-trib rapture, or that the rapture has to be on Feast of Trumpets, live or die. They live and die on some hill that the Lord didn't call them to fall on the sword upon. Brothers and sisters, praise be to God, creator of heaven and earth, the Most High God, El Elyon in Hebrew. He is the Most High God, creator of heaven and earth. And brothers and sisters, what I don't have a dog in the hunt about, it's about celebrating the feast or not, whether we should celebrate the feast or not. I'm neutral on it and open to it, brothers and sisters. That being said, this morning, or just a few minutes ago, as I've been seeking the Lord about revival, the Lord's been talking about revival. He is going to send a revival of holy fire, of holiness and righteousness, like in the days of John Wesley, similar to that. But everything that the Lord does is always a little bit different in the way he sends revival and the way the Spirit operates. And that's what I was been trying to make videos about. But the Lord has rested me on that and going any further with it. But I will just tell you that the Lord is in revival. No man knows the day or the hour. It literally means that, besides the fact it could refer to the Feast of Trumpets. But no one literally knows the day or the hour when the rapture will be. We cannot calculate it. And we will not be able to calculate it. And it will happen suddenly. Whenever the Lord wills it to happen, whenever the Father says that our mansions are ready, he will release the Son to come get us, as the Lord referred to John chapter 14. He went to prepare a place for us. That's another message, brothers and sisters. Here's the message that the Lord gave me. I want to read some texts to you. And really the title of my sermon is we are celebrate the resurrection of our Lord. Like that song, celebrate, come on and celebrate the resurrection of our Lord. Celebrate, Jesus, celebrate, the Don Moen song. Let's see. John chapter 7, listen to this. John was an Israelite. And as a matter of fact, John was first cousins with Jesus. A lot of people don't know that. But the apostle John was the first cousin of Jesus. His mother, Salome, is the sister of Mary. If you study out the Gospels, you'll find that to be true. I made a video and mentioned that a long time ago, way back. FYI, it doesn't matter, but it's just a FYI. Anyway, John chapter 7. This is the Apostle John, who was a Jew and lived as a Jew. He said, after these things, Jesus walked in Galilee, for he would not walk in jewelry amongst the Jews, because the Jews sought to kill him. Now see, by the time John wrote his Gospels, way up in about, he wrote this in, say, 90 or 92 A.D., you know, the nation of Israel had soundly rejected Christianity as a cult. When it first started, they were curious, you know, and they were open to it, and there were lots of Jews who came in. And then there was a breaking point between Judaism and Christianity broke off as not a sect of Judaism, but its own religion. You know, this is a whole new thing, Christianity. And the time, like when Paul said, I will no longer go to the Jews, we will no longer go to the Jews, but to the Gentiles. I believe that's in Corinth. But anyway, let's go back here. Where am I at? John chapter 1. Okay, and you know, he will no longer walk in Judea because the Jews sought to kill him. Now the Jews, listen to this. Now the Jews' feast of tabernacles was at hand. This is John, who was an Israelite, the disciple whom Jesus loved, who wrote Revelation that you love to quote, who wrote the Gospel of John in 1st, 2nd, and 3rd John. Next, you know, he was the closest to Jesus. He's the one who leaned his head on the chest of Jesus and said, who will betray you at the Last Supper? Because Peter asked John, hey, ask him who's going to betray him. You know, who's he going to be? John was the youngest disciple. They say he was just a teenager, like 17, 18 years old, during the ministry of Jesus. And he's the one who, the disciple whom Jesus loved. He's the one who got the book of Revelation. The only one who didn't die by martyrdom was John. He's the only one who lived to old age. And he wrote the Gospel of John. And here he is saying, now the Jews' feast of tabernacles was at hand. The Jews' feast. Can you get that? The Jews' feast. His brethren therefore said unto him, to Jesus, go up to, depart hence into Judea, that thy disciples may see the works that thou doest. I don't want to sit here and read the whole text, but when Jesus went up to the feast, Jesus went up to the feast in John chapter 7. Let's see. Now, when the feast was going, let's skip ahead. Now, it was at the end of the feast. It explains all about it there in John chapter 7. In the last day of the Feast of Tabernacles, what they would do, you can read in the footnotes in your Bible, you can look it up. They used to take this this water. Let's see, my Bible has a description about it too. They would take this water and they would pour it out, brothers and sisters. They would take it, this thing of water, and keep pouring it out on those days of the feast. See, Feast of Tabernacles. Jesus visited the Feast of Booths, or Tabernacles, approximately early October, and was debated by his half-brothers about 6 months prior to the crucifixion. During this feast, for 6 consecutive days, a procession of priests carried water in golden vessels into the temple area. Then pouring the water was thought to be physical and spiritual significance. See, it was thought to be spiritual and physical significance. On the seventh day, the great day, no water was carried. It was then that Jesus stood and taught of the rivers of living water, especially the significance of the Holy Spirit. See this? So on the seventh day, they went into the temple. And Jesus stands up and says, if any man thirst, let him come to me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. This he spake of the Spirit, which they had believed, which they that believed on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost had not yet been given, because Jesus had not yet been glorified. On the Feast of Dedication, brothers and sisters, a.k.a. Hanukkah, Jesus went up to the temple and stood there. They light the the menorah. They light it every day. And then, you know, the miracle of the oil lasting 7 days instead of the one-day supply they had. Jesus stood in front of that and said, I'm the light of the world. You know, when they have the showbread in the temple, he stood up there and said, I'm the bread of life. In other words, all of those feasts are fulfilled in Christ. So you guys, this is from the Spirit of the living God. For God has called me to a prophetic ministry. And to call out, you know, as in the spirit of his servants, like John the Baptist and all those guys, to call the people to truth and repentance. To truth and repentance. Brothers and sisters, those are types and shadows of the better things to come, the book of Hebrews tells us. The better things to come, which is Jesus, Yeshua. Many of you are celebrating something from the law of Moses, one of the feasts of the Jews, as the Apostle John said. And then the Lord has called us to celebrate the fulfillment of all those things in Christ. I'm fulfilling that Jesus is the Word of God. Jesus is the announcement and pronouncement of God in the world, brothers and sisters. He is the fulfillment of all things. All things is fulfilled in Christ. This is the Bible verse that the Lord gave me for you guys. And I read this text from Romans chapter 6. I've taught on it about that we need to be sanctified in holiness. I've read out of this text. The Lord has led me to this text to teach you guys about holiness, that we're not supposed to live in sin. And the Lord has used me to teach you about the text about baptism, about water baptism is by submersions, that we're to be buried with Christ. Now in the same text, Romans chapter 6, verse 5, and if we are planted, it's talking about water baptism, together in the likeness of his death, we shall also in the likeness of his resurrection, knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we shall not serve sin. The point is that we will be in the likeness of his resurrection, in the likeness of Christ. Brothers and sisters, the whole theme, the whole point, the whole idea, the whole concept of the New Testament is that God made a new and a better covenant and a living way in Christ. All those acts of the law, brothers and sisters, have been fulfilled in Christ. He fulfilled all things in him. We don't need to go to any tabernacle. What does it say? As a matter of fact, the Lord gave me another text. He gave me another text. Hebrews chapter 13. Let me find it. Hebrews chapter 13. Hebrews chapter 13. Listen to this. All ye stiff-necked and hard-hearted people who try to fulfill your own righteousness by keeping the works of the law, not knowing that the letter of the law brings death, but the spirit of the law brings life in Christ Jesus. What does it say? Where's the verse at now? Let me get to it. Because I wasn't prepared to use this verse, but the Lord had given it to me earlier, and I was going to meditate on it more. Let's see what it says. It says, we have an altar. He's talking to the Hebrews. We have an altar wherefore they have no right to eat, which serve the tabernacle. Those people who are practicing Judaism have no right to eat at the table we have. What is our table? The Lord's Supper. The communion that we have with Christ, not celebrating Passover, not going into the literal temple on the Temple Mount. We have a different table. It's called the Lord's table, the love feast, where we sit down. Jesus said, many people come from the east and the west and sit down with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob while the children of the kingdom are put out, the Jewish people who refuse to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. We have an altar whereof they have no right to eat. This is Hebrews chapter 13, verse 10. Which served the tabernacle. Are you talking about the descendants of Aaron that some of you think you are Jews and are not? Some of you Judaizers think are so great that someone is a Kohen. They have no right. They have no right to sit down. The lowest Gentile, it doesn't matter. Just like, you know, in the Song of Solomon, you know, she says, I'm dark and ruddy and all this and you know, a runt and not a beautiful woman. But yet she is the love of Solomon's life, this Gentile girl. And of course, it's a type of Christ in the Gentile church. Let's see. For the verse 11, for the bodies of those beasts, which blood is brought into the sanctuary by the high priest for sins, are burned without the camp, outside the camp. Wherefore Jesus also, that he might sanctify the people with his own blood, suffered outside the gate. Let us go forth therefore unto him outside the camp, bearing his reproach. For here have we no continuing city, but we seek one that is to come. What part? This refers back to the text from Hebrews chapter 12, where it says Moses and the children of Israel were at Mount Horeb, where even Moses was, you know, trembling and full of fear with the lightning and all that, and even if a beast touched a mountain, it'll be killed and all that. We didn't come to that. We're not under the law, but we have come to Mount Zion. You know, to the assembly of the church of the firstborn and the holy angels and, you know, the Jesus and God there from Hebrews chapter 12. That's where we've come to. It's a whole new covenant, a new and living way. Why is it that the Lord has set you free? How is it that you've been so bewitched, as Paul asked the Galatians? How is it that you were set free and filled with the Holy Spirit? Were you filled with the Holy Spirit by keeping the law? Were you saved by keeping the law, as Paul asked the Galatians? How is it you've been so easily bewitched to go back into bondage, as the Bible tells us in Galatians, that the slave woman, the bond woman, who is the mother of Ishmael, which links right to Islam, as a matter of fact, that the bond servant Hagar is a type of Israel, and we, the church, are the type of promise, Sarah and Isaac. That's the child of promise. You know, a child that was not supposed to be born, that's born by a miracle, not by the natural flesh. Even as Jesus was born of a virgin, even Isaac was born to a 90-year-old woman and a 100-year-old dad. That's why his name is Isaac Laughter. He's the child of promise, a child. There's no way a 90-year-old woman can have a baby in the natural. It was a supernatural thing. But yet Hagar, who was a young woman, of course, she could naturally have a baby. There is Ishmael. So Hagar, as Paul tells us in Galatians, is a bond servant and a bond woman and a slave woman, and she is the type of the nation of Israel. And then Sarah and her son Isaac, the child of promise, is a type of the church. Brothers and sisters, you need to be celebrating the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the fulfillment of all things in Christ, not celebrating those things that are a type and a shadow, and giving heed to doctrines and fables of men after the lineages of men and all of the blood of bulls and goats. For all has been fulfilled in the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah. By the grace of God, may you not be caught in the trap of self-righteousness and deeds of the law. For by the deeds of the law shall no flesh be justified. It is by grace are you saved through faith, not of your own, but a gift of God, not by works, lest any man should boast. Hallelujah. It is through the blood, the shedding of the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah, that you've been forgiven. You've been redeemed. You've been saved by grace, not by keeping of the law, not by keeping of the works of the nation of Israel. For Israel to this day is perishing until they accept Jesus Christ as a fulfillment of the law, brothers and sisters, and become born again, just like you and me. What does it say? God calls all men everywhere to repent. All men need to repent. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Those who are servants of Christ, that's the real Israel, the Bible says. Those who have circumcised their hearts and not their flesh. Brothers and sisters, don't be caught up. Don't be caught up in false doctrines. This is part of the end times deception, brothers and sisters. The nation of Israel themselves, don't worry about them. They will be saved. The Lord's going to deal with Israel. And they're not saved. They will be saved when they accept Jesus Christ as their Messiah. When he returns, it says they will mourn for the one they pierced. They will receive Jesus in the end. Brothers and sisters, they will receive Jesus in the end. We, brothers and sisters, we Gentiles, we need to win the world to Jesus Christ. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. Brothers and sisters, we are called to celebrate the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. Not on just Saturday or Sunday or Monday or Tuesday, but every day. You want to go back and look, Acts, people talking about they went in the temple in Acts in the beginning. It says they broke bread daily. What does that mean? They took communion daily, the Lord's table, the Lord's supper daily. They went from house to house and fellowshiped and celebrated the resurrection of Jesus daily. Every day we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Our rest, Hebrews chapter 3, verse 3:12, I believe it is, through all of Hebrews chapter 4, it tells us that our Sabbath day is a rest that's by faith in the finished work of Christ, brothers and sisters. Think not with your carnal mind. Get out of your carnal, earthly, Old Testament mind and get into the New Testament, into the Spirit of the living God. I pray right now in the name of Jesus that you be baptized in his Holy Spirit, that you might not have the mind of carnal-minded men, but the mind of the living God. The Bible says those who are filled with his Spirit, we have the mind of Christ. Hallelujah. May you be filled with the mind of Christ, that you might start thinking not in the flesh, in the natural, in the mind of Hagar, in the mind of a bondservant, but be free from the law of sin and death. Hallelujah. We've been delivered from the curse of the law. Praise be God Almighty that has cleansed us of all unrighteousness by his blood, by his Spirit, and by his word. May you be washed in his word today. May you be set free from all the doctrines of men and fables of men, that you might learn to live and walk by the Spirit of the living God. For Romans chapter 8, verse 16, verse 14, those who are led by the Spirit, these are the sons of God. John chapter 1, don't let anybody fool you that Israelites are the sons of God. What does it say? It says in John chapter 1, again, John the apostle, John, the closest disciple to Jesus, he said right in John chapter 1, to many who has received Jesus, to them he gave power to become the sons of God. To be a son of God means to be a born again Christian, brothers and sisters. Not after the natural seed of Abraham, but the spiritual seed of Abraham. We are adopted children of God by faith in Christ. Hallelujah. We become the children of the promise, the children of faith. Just as Abraham believed God, and it was accounted unto him as righteousness. Romans chapter 4, it's a righteousness that cometh by faith, not by the doing of the law, brothers and sisters. Stop being sin-minded and sin-focused and sin-consciousness. but have a consciousness that is in Christ, that's free in Christ. Hallelujah. If you go, brothers and sisters, let me just say it as simply as I can. One of the biggest things that people talk to me about is trying to stop their sin. And I say unto you, by the Spirit of the living God, if you were to go right now and go into the sun, if you could fly right now into the sun, you wouldn't have to worry about no darkness being on you. Because the closer you got to that sun, there's a point when you get close to the sun, you're going to be set on fire. You're going to burn up, and you won't be no more you. You will become part of the sun. That's the same way to live your life. Stop running from sin and trying to control sin by your own flesh, by your own mind, your own weaknesses, but run into Jesus, who is the author and finisher of our faith. And there is no righteousness, there is no salvation outside of Christ. He is the ark. He is the fulfillment of all things. He is the Holy of Holies, the Most High God. He is the sanctuary. He's the tabernacle of the witness. He is the glory of God manifested in the flesh, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Run to Him, and all the things of this world will fall away from you. Brothers and sisters, in Him there's light and no shadow of turning. There's no darkness in Jesus. No sin can stand in His presence. Run into His presence and all of your problems will flee away, brothers and sisters, from the flesh, your sin. All your sin problems, all of the imperfections in you will be burnt up in Christ, brothers and sisters. That's the secret. That is the will of God for us, His church, to be near Him, to press into Him, to walk with Him. Let Him lead us as a pillar of fire by night and a cloud by day. Follow Him. For the Bible says, Romans chapter 8, 16, His Spirit bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And 14, those who are led by His Spirit, these are the children of God. Let Him lead you by His Spirit. That's the problem with all these people that's got all these troubles and turmoils who talk to me. You've got to be led by His Spirit. You've got to be led by His Spirit. You can't be led by your own natural vain imaginations. You can't be led by the law. Moses can't lead you. All these Judaizers can't lead you. Having a prayer shawl or a yarmulke is not going to make you holy. Having a menorah is not going to make you holy. Those things are all shadows. Shadows and types of the good things that are here in Christ Jesus today. I beseech ye, brethren, therefore now that you offer yourselves as a living sacrifice unto the Lord. Romans chapter 12. You know, and give Him the sacrifice of praise. Offer your life to Him. Let the Lord use you. You want to be filled with the Spirit, but yet you don't want to do anything. You're Dead Sea Christians. You know, in the Dead Sea, the River Jordan ends down there at the Dead Sea, and it flows in and nothing flows out. That's why they call it the Dead Sea. Nothing flows out of it. You got to be like the Sea of Galilee. If you want to be filled with the Spirit of God, you have to be like the Sea of Galilee. The Jordan River flows into it, and then it also flows out. Why does God bless you? He told Abraham, I bless you to make you a blessing. You want to operate in the power of God, in the anointing of God? It's not to be consumed on your own lust, but God will bless you that you might become a blessing. Now, therefore, I beseech thee, brethren, that you offer your body as a living sacrifice. You say, Lord, here I am. Use me. Send me. Mold me. Shape me. Break me. Humble yourselves. Humble yourselves, you high-minded, stiff-necked, hard-hearted people. And let the Lord turn you in, that His word would be fulfilled in you. In the Hebrews chapter 12, verse 29, that our God is a consuming fire. Let the Lord consume up your old rotten, imperfect, sin-filled flesh. And let Him make you a new creature in Christ today. Call upon the name of the Lord Jesus and say, Lord, I've been unfaithful. I've been living in sin. I've been unworthy. I've been selfish, haughty, high-minded, arrogant. Lord, fill me with a spirit of humility. For your word says you give grace to the humble, but you resist the proud. Lord, consume me with your love. Consume me with your grace. Consume me with your Holy Spirit, Lord God, that I might bear fruit of your Spirit, Lord God, that I might have the unction and the character to serve you, Lord God. Father, conform me to the image of Christ, even as your word declares. Lord, set me free from the law of sin and death, that I might abound in your grace, Lord God. Hallelujah. Set me free, Lord, for your word says those whom the Son has set free are free indeed, Lord God. So, Lord, I come to you and know that I'm bound in religion. I'm bound in the traditions of man. I'm bound in Roman Catholicism. I've been bound in all the wicked ideas and the cunning devices of men. And Lord, I come to you right now and humbly submit myself to be a seeker of you, Lord Jesus. Not religion, not denominations, not man-made doctrines, not fables of men, not Judaism, but I've come, Lord, to be set free in Christ, to be a follower of Jesus, not a follower of men. That I would abide in you, Lord, and you would abide in me. That I would walk with you and you'd walk with me. I would sup with you and you would sup with me. That I would commune with you and you would commune with me. That where you are, I may be there also, Lord. Hallelujah. For you're coming for a bride without spot or blemish. And they're made righteous by the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. And the word of their testimony. Not by the deeds of the law. For no flesh shall be justified by the deeds of the law. Brother and sisters, God is going to send revival of holy fire. Holiness upon his people. Holiness. Holiness. With signs and wonders following. But we don't chase after signs and wonders. Signs and wonders chases after his people. Hallelujah. For he said, in my name they'll cast out devils. In my name they'll lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. They will speak with new tongues. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We'll do all those things in Christ. Those signs and wonders will follow us, brothers and sisters. But that's not what it's about, brothers and sisters. It's all about Jesus. Like that song. I'm sorry, Lord, for the things I've made it. But it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the things I've made it. But it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I want you to sing that to the Lord. Tell him you're sorry for everything you've made it. But it's all about him. It's all about Jesus. To celebrate the resurrection of our Lord. Jesus Christ has risen. He has conquered the grave. He's overcome the grave by his spirit. The spirit of the living God. Jesus said, no man takes my life. I have the power to lay it down and the power to take it back up again. Hallelujah. He is the good shepherd. Hallelujah. He has fulfilled all things in himself. Hallelujah. For God himself, hallelujah, has done this thing. God is our salvation. Not ourselves or our works or our deeds of the law, but God himself is our salvation. Hallelujah. He is the redeemer of man. He's the author and finisher of our faith. He is the author of life, the creator of life. Hallelujah. In him we live and breathe and have our being. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord on high. Hallelujah. He is worthy of all praise, worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Exalt the Lord our God. Hallelujah. Praise his name. Exalt the Lord our God. Hallelujah. We exalt the Lord our God. Hallelujah. He is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Blessing and honor and praise and glory. Hallelujah. Be unto his name. Hallelujah. Take your rest in Christ, for his burden is easy and his yoke is light. Matthew chapter 11. Think not that you'll be justified by the deeds of the law. Hallelujah. Don't let any Judaizers try to bind you up. Don't let any cults like Jehovah's Witnesses, Mormons, Roman Catholicism, all these religions that try to bind up heavy burdens on people's back, creating a form of godliness but denying the power thereof. Hallelujah. Salvation is a work of God alone. Hallelujah. He's the one. Hallelujah. He's the one that called us unto himself. Praise be God. He called me. He sought me and he bought me. And with his redeeming blood, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm not my own, but I've been bought with a price. Hallelujah. The precious blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. Not the blood of bulls and goats or the Feast of Trumpets or the Feast of Tabernacles or Passover blood that was for Israelites when they came out of Egypt, but the blood of the Lamb, of the Lamb, hallelujah, that takes away the sins of the world. Behold, the Lamb of God, not a bunch of lambs, but one Lamb, hallelujah. He is the fulfillment and completion of all things. He's the Alpha and Omega, our Deliverer, our King, our Lord, and our God, Yeshua, hallelujah. He is a mighty God, hallelujah. He is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. He has set all the enemy's works at naught. By his word, by his spirit, by his glory. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, brothers and sisters. He is worthy of all praise and glory. Lord, there is none like you. There is none like you. I worship you, O mighty God. There is none like you. I worship you, O King of kings. There is none like you. Lord, hallelujah, blessed be his holy name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be his holy name. Hallelujah. 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 Halakuna masiba yasuki daromusa barayama. Hakuma da debusa maya. Hukina masima yasikinananamu. The Lord is just saying that whomsoever will, let him come drink freely from the river of life. Hallelujah. Any who thirst, let him come after me, for out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. Hallelujah. I am the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Hallelujah. And my come quickly and my reward is with me. Hallelujah. I'm sovereign over this nation, all over the world. Hallelujah. The Lord is sovereign God. Hallelujah. As he taught us through the book of Daniel. Hallelujah. That the Lord is a sovereign God. Hallelujah. Over the affairs of men. Hallelujah. He raises up whom he will, and he tears down and breaks down whom he will. Hallelujah. For he is the King of kings and the Lord of lords, sovereign over all the earth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All things are restored in Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There is a Redeemer who is a King. Hallelujah. He is the Messiah, the Savior, the Deliverer, the Anointed One of God. Hallelujah. Who goes before him, 10,000 of his saints. Hallelujah. Praise before his throne. Hallelujah. For he is to be exalted and worthy of praise. Hallelujah. He is Yeshua, HaMashiach, the Savior. Hallelujah. The fairest of 10,000. Hallelujah. The Balm of Gilead. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, the rose of Sharon, hallelujah, the lily of the valley, he is the Savior, the Messiah, the soon coming King, our Deliverer, hallelujah, hallelujah. He was the snake that was lifted up in the wilderness because the Word of God says he became sin for us, hallelujah, hallelujah. Look upon your sin, for the Lord said, as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so shall the Son of Man be lifted up. And if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. Therefore, look unto your sin. Hallelujah. For it is on the cross with Yeshua HaMashiach. The Mashiach has taken your sin upon himself. Hallelujah. He has delivered you from the snare of the foe. He has delivered you from the curse of the law. He has delivered you from the works of men. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He is a light unto the Gentiles and a deliverer unto his people Israel. Hallelujah. He is the most sanctified Holy One of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name. Hallowed be his name. Hallelujah. He is the great King, the Deliverer of Israel. Hallelujah. And the King of kings and the Lord over all of Jerusalem. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name, our God Most High. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Fulfilled the work of Adam. Hallelujah. By living the law of sinlessness. Hallelujah. Tempted in every way, but without sin. Hallelujah. The second Adam. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name. Blessed be his name, God Most High. Brothers and sisters, God has taken, as you can see, the Lord is taking the revival and the ministry to a new level, brothers and sisters. And the Lord is leading me to walk upon the water and take no mind to entertain the carnal-minded critics. I usually, by the grace of God, I've been able to overcome their, you know, they have not been able to gainsay against me by the Spirit of God, that I've been able to deal with all these doctrinal issues, brothers and sisters. The ministry I've done on YouTube in the past has been going up and, you know, always catching every doctrinal foolishness as I make my videos, you know, and laying that out, weaving it in my videos, correct doctrine and theology, plainly and simply from the Bible. My brothers and sisters, the Lord has called me, you know, to go over the top of the mountain, to go on, because I've seen the mountain of God, and the Lord has called me to go on up the mountain, brothers and sisters, and praise God, I'm going to take y'all with me. As high as the Lord let me go, you're going to go with me, brothers and sisters. I'm not going to deal and discuss anymore with disputes of men. Because, you know, I've been through that season, and Lord, I've got those, all the videos I made in that season of my walk with the Lord in the ministry that God gave me. Now is the time, brothers and sisters, to go over the top of the fence, to go over the top of the mountain, to go on into the holy place and on into the Holy of Holies. Go, you know, we've been out here in the court of the Gentiles, out here dealing with all the nonsense and foolishness, you know, and trying to bring people into an understanding of the Word of God. Now is the time to go on in over into the glory land, brothers and sisters. Time for revival, time to take things on to the higher level. So my time with using my brain that the Lord gave me, the anointing that he gave me to try to dispute all those doctrinal things, and try to explain those, which I've done in all these videos. You can go back and watch it and see all these doctrines that people come up with. Go back and see, I've made videos about all that stuff. You can get any question answered or discussed that you can think of just about. But brothers and sisters, it's time to go on. It's time to go on from glory to glory, from line upon line, precept upon precept. It's time to go on to revival. It's time to go on to, you know, it's just flowing from the throne and not, and be still before the Lord. It's what I say to people, be still before the Lord. You know, I'm just going to speak from the Lord and not entertain conversations about it. So that period is over with, brothers and sisters. God bless you guys. God bless you guys. And of course, the higher we go, you know, we sometimes go through turbulence as we're going to a higher altitude. But the Lord's got it all, brothers and sisters. He's got it all in the palm of his hand. It's not my business anymore, not my problems. I'm going on higher. I'm going on up the mountain. I've been at the bottom of the mountain, you know, trying to help people get on the mountain and trying to get the devil's people off the, you know, from trying to climb on the mountain, you know, in an unauthorized way, trying to find another way to get on the mountain except through the blood of Jesus. And now it's time to go up higher on the mountain, brothers and sisters. I love you guys. Those of you who can make it with me, come on, let's go. Let's go on up the mountain. Let's get into higher things of God, into the glory of God. Hallelujah. Let's get into the Shekinah glory of God. Let's get into the holiness of God. Let's hear him speak to us from the top of the mountain, brothers and sisters. Let's go. Let's go. God bless you guys. Have a blessed day. Every day we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord. And today happens to be Sunday. The Lord Jesus was resurrected on the first day of the week, which is today. And that's why most people choose Sunday. But every day we should celebrate the fact that Jesus has resurrected it. Romans chapter 6, verse 5, that, you know, we're buried with him in baptism, will also be as him in the resurrection when he comes back for the rapture of the church. God bless you guys.